Hello and welcome to Colin's Time to Bake. Thank you for joining me. Today is the 2nd of December and I'm starting to make some Christmassy bakes. My first bake that I have done is my gingerbread old Christmas tree decorations. They look a little bit something like this. And you can make them for to hang on your Christmas tree or just to give away as presents. First things first, we're going to need our ingredients. So everybody, get ready and raise your hands. One, two, three. Ta-da! I've got the ingredients here for both the gingerbread and the icing. Here's a quick run through of what you will need for today's bake.
Press pause now and collect everything you need. I'll wait.
So there you have it. Is everybody ready? Let's get started. There are two ways to make this gingerbread. You can do it all in the food processor or in two stages like I am today. Start off using a big bowl and put in 350 grams of plain flour. Add to this 1 teaspoon of bicarbonate of soda, 1 tablespoon of ginger and 1 teaspoon of cinnamon. Mix this together and add in 175 grams of light brown sugar. Now put this into your food processor if you haven't already done so and add in 125 grams of unsalted butter. Blend this all together until it makes fine breadcrumbs. Then add 1/2 teaspoon of orange extract and pulse this again together to mix it all through. Then get 1 egg and blend it in lightly, then add 3 tablespoons of golden syrup. Mix the egg and the golden syrup together and then pour into your mix in the food processor. Pulse this together until the mix forms one dough. Then pour out onto a well-floured surface and knead together until you form a ball. Wrap this up in cling film and then put into the fridge for 15 to 20 minutes. Once you take it out of the fridge, put it onto a well-floured surface and roll into a 0.5 centimeter thickness. Now you want to start cutting your shapes. What I'm doing is using a Christmas tree for my decoration. You of course don't have to use Christmas trees. You can use gingerbread men or any other shapes of cookies that you want to. It doesn't really matter because you're making your own decoration, so you do as you feel. For the decoration, you'll obviously want to be hanging this, so you want to make sure there's a hole big enough to put a ribbon through at the top. So cut a hole out using whatever you wish. Place these into the fridge for 20 minutes. This will ensure that the shape is kept while you're baking. While your cookies are chilling in the fridge, switch on your oven to 160 degrees or 150 degrees fan. Then place into the oven for 10 minutes or until golden brown. If your cookies don't turn out exactly like they should and spread a little, you can go over this with the cutter and slice it down like I'm doing here. You can cheat, it's okay. And then obviously cut out the hole again. Once the cookies have cooled, it's time to start decorating. Now I found that the best thing to use is actually Royal Icing, which I will quickly go through just now. Sieve 675 grams of icing sugar in a bowl, and then in another bowl you need to use 3 egg whites whisked until frothy. Fold in your icing sugar, then add 3 tablespoons of lemon juice and 1.5 teaspoons of glycerin. This will make your royal icing. Put your royal icing into a piping bag and then it's time to start decorating. If you are giving them out as presents, it's quite nice to know that someone's got their own individual cookie. You can do front and back, but obviously make sure that the icing has hardened on one side before you pipe onto the other side. Finally, and possibly most importantly for the fact that you're making a decoration, you need to hang a ribbon through the hole and this will help it dangle off the Christmas tree. So there you have it, our gingerbread old Christmas tree decorations. Of course you can make any other decoration you feel, it doesn't have to be a Christmas tree, as long as it's festive. Thank you very much for joining me. Don't forget you can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and click the big red button here to subscribe to my channel for all future bakes. My name is Colin, this is Colin's Time to Bake. We'll see you soon.